Pas comme ça.
Thank you, ma.
I don't know this. Problem is that the thing is not projecting. I don't know. It's not projected. Okay, let me be sharing it on Zoom because I don't know. It's, okay, good morning, everybody. Please, let's start off. It's a serious business. I don't believe in African time. Even I live in Africa, I was brought up not to do African time. I'm used to not doing African time. And that's why it gets on my nerves when people are doing African time with me. Okay. Poor mistake. This is not projecting. I don't know what else we do, but I don't know. I don't know because it's very, very important. I said you are going to also join with Zoom, but make sure you are muted. So you can, because I'm already sharing it on Zoom. So if you join on Zoom, then you can be muted, then we can see go on like that. So good morning, everybody. Thank you for coming. Yeah, I actually used my personal PB CV to do the eventual what's it called? To eventually do the preparation of the sample that I'm going to use. So we start with doing some looking at some this the what's it called now? All these people that are joining and joining. Okay. So we start with the looking at the maybe I should also have printed this thing set. Then we use it. Please, can we put our phones on silent to make it easy for us to work together? Please. Mine is already on silent. It's not projected. But there's nothing I can do. Okay, so let me continue. Okay, now the topic that we are going, when we had the last meeting, please let's mute it. When it's time for me to talk, but I will be disturbing the work here. Is that okay? But you can see you will see the slides online. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to look at is the what do we mean by CV? Now, what we need to understand about when we talk about CV is this. It is telling us that every story about yourself professionally This is where you tell it. And that is, it is a Latin word that means the people in Latin here should. Yeah, I hope we all have the sample CV that has been given to us by Apple. I hope we all have it. Because I following the guide, that's how I am doing it slide by slide for us to look at. Because at the last exercise, at a stage, one of our leaders had to say that this is not, and there are some levels that you get to, you cannot be excused anymore. And some of you, I think everybody at that level that cannot be excused anymore, made a mess of the CV. So, one of our leaders had to say that, please, Dean, tell them this is not acceptable. I said, yes, they have to understand that if this thing goes out like this, nobody will even look at it, they will throw it away. That is the truth. I'm sure the former deans, I was hoping they would be here to come and tell us their experiences. They will throw it away. And that is because what is expected of you at a level cannot be excused. And that's why even when we are looking at, oh, this one is at everything, when you're at that level, it's okay. It's just, let's just, when you get to a level, nobody will patch you again. So, and this is very important. Some of the things we saw at the CP, they were not good at all. So, and that's why we just have to do this. And even though I was in almost 3 days, but I just told myself I have to do this. And it was even yesterday evening, I was just struggling to prepare this thing because for 3 days now, I've been down seriously. Down. I even forgot this morning. It was later I remember to eat food so that I can take my food. But this has to be done so that we can submit a report. Now, in simple English, it is a written overview of it. Of your life, so that's what your CV is about. And for me, it is where you package yourself to sell yourself to the world. So it is very important that we know that it is not just, it should be just for promotion. Let us just give them. That is not just for promotion. If it's not done right, can be enough to deny you of that promotion. And that is just why it is very important that we know this. So they're saying your curriculum vitae is normally shortly called the CV. The detailed presentation of who you are, what you have achieved, and every single detail that has to do with your personal life. And as a scholar, as an academic, you have to have a CV that can speak for you. Huh. So as an academic, this includes your teaching, your research activities, and your communication, as well as your community service. So these are the things that, so these are three the cardinal points of the activities involved around academia of teaching, research, and community service. So all these things are the things that you have been done there. Now, what is the noun format of a CV? And this is very important because the thing you also know is that every institution, it doesn't have that. It doesn't have that. The system doesn't have that. You cannot share it, so you can only use HDMI with it. Or check the back. It doesn't have. Hey, what happened? Now, University has a format, which you have here. Everybody has been given a copy. I want. Is there anybody that does not have this? My FO told me she give me everybody. Is there anybody that does not have? FO, somebody say he does not have. The head of the government is saying that it doesn't have. This is what? This is the only format we have for now, so it has not changed. Okay. Please, you are not muted. Many of us are not muted. Yes, I understand the point you are making, but I've always found personal way around that. I was even discussing that with her this morning. And what was I telling her? I said, yes, some of these things were in the first one that was given to us before this one was given. But then I make sure I supply all those pieces of information as you are going to see as you are going. As you are going to see as you are going. That's why I've always done my, I've already put my administrative experience, all those things there. So I've never left them out. That is who you are. I've never left them out. So but we are going to see. So we are going to follow this TV format. Okay, sir. Okay. Yeah. Your own case is a different matter, and I will mention it as I'm going along. So what happened to your own was a different matter, but we are going to talk about it. So you can just prepare in line with your organization. So you are required that if you are applying somewhere, you use the format as you are in now, and the information you are looking for is for now, then you follow the format given by now. So we are going to see as we go on. So then another important thing I need to mention before we start is that your CV is who you are. So there's a common thing about CV that is it presents your professional outlook. Why I'm saying all this is for us to know how important it is for our CV to speak for us. You may not be there where people will talk about you, but it could be what to undo you if you are not if your CV is not really properly done. So this is why it is very important. So you have no excuse for sloppiness in your self-presentation. There is no excuse at all. If you don't know how to write good English, get people. We are not muted, please. We are mute yourself. Mute yourself, please. Mute yourself. Abubakar is not muted. Bibian is not muted. So please mute yourself. Now, what am I saying? That it is what sells you. Now, as a senior person, nobody will excuse you. So that is very, very important for you to know. So your CV is your professional outlook, and it must be virtually flawless. You know, there's nothing that is perfect. Nobody is perfect. But you should get to the point that your error should be so low that it could be able to be excused. And that's what we are talking about here. So let's go on. So the first thing in now detail in now CV are your personal details. And you have it 1, 2, up to I think number what now? Somebody is echoing there, please. I don't know. We have been doing Zoom meeting in this university. We should know some of these things. We should not be. So now you begin with your personal details. And we're going to be following, like I said, the CV format one by one. So the first thing is this. Like you can see there, like I said, I'm using mine. So the first thing is that your name. Yeah, now your last name comes last and is underlined to show that it is your surname. That's the way now write the name. It's not first name, surname first. It's always surname last. And then you also underline. That's what is required if you look at your CV format. Now, the next one is the date of birth. Now, if you have a former name, now I use my former name here because I had the name that I used to publish before. And now I'm presenting with a new name. So definitely for them to connect, so how do you do it now? You don't have to. So for you to be able to connect yourself to the publications. So I had to do that. But it may not concern if you don't have that issue. So I just put that as an example also. Just to say, oh, when you send some of my publication, why is this name this and all of that? So that's why I decided to put that. Otherwise, I didn't put that first. Then date of birth follows. Then your department and your faculty. That is number one. If you look at it, your number one is that. It is there, number one. So all the details that are required. And then you will notice I put column after each one. Then there's aligning. Because we also have that problem in some of your presentations. You see there's a block aligning of the information being provided to those things. I think we can see that. I want to believe you are seeing that from where you are connecting, if you are joined the Zoom meeting, because I'm projecting it. I think you can see that.
Are we seeing it?
Okay, thank you very much.
See.
Thank you very much, sir. So that is, you see, it is in form. I am putting that one up just because it, I'm using it as the title of the slide. If not, I could have put it here, just the way it is. But it should align. Hold on. Now, where I also say your punctuation mark is important is that you do not punctuate your name, your date of birth. You do not do that. Is that okay? You don't do that. Some of us going to associate professor by doing that. And this was at the stage that the professor English could not still mark this thing anymore. They had to tell him, say, Dean, please, this is not acceptable. I say, yes, I noticed these things too. So the next one, the net number two on that list is that you now have your first academic appointment, your president post with date, your date of last promotion, then your date last considered, if it's applicable. If it's not, you say not applicable. That is somebody that I've maybe put in for promotion before then, it didn't stay through. So then your position sought. Now for me, because anyway, this my CV is just kind of a mix because it's an old CV, but just putting some new details and something like that. So I'm putting I was looking for the one I used to apply, but I could not get it, like I've updated it. So that's why I don't have to use this one to do this presentation. I tried to use that so that I can really give you what I'm talking about. But now, for you that you are looking for promotion, you will have to put, if you have been considered before, you put when you are last considered. But if you are not, no problem. You say not applicable. Then you put position sort. You put your position. But you see again, there's column in front of each of these things, and then the format is blocked. So this is proper way that it is neat and tidy. So we don't want it mixed up. Some of you, some are going to the left, some is going to that, you're putting full stop. Please do not do that. So that is very, very important. Let's go to the next thing. Now you have your number three is your university education with this. Number three, because the other one, I actually used personal details for the first time, but I saw the personal details include all these things. That was why I decided to just say I used the number as the title of the slide. Now, when you look at it again, I put the university I attended, then the dates that I attended. So that is your number three. Then you see again, tidily arranged. Then we see again your academic qualification with this. Now, because this is, I wanted to maintain the broadness of the this thing. In your own, it won't be as broad. It's not, the title of the slide will not be as high as this. So what you have is that it will be on one line. It won't be flowing down to another line, like, because you'll not be using the kind of font I used it. You'll be using the font that is normal, like maybe your 13-point font. So of course, it will be able to stay on one line. It won't spill over like this one is spilling over. So you see now that again, you make sure that it's aligned and it is in format. So I see some of us, we are using table, it is not necessary. If you know how to use tabs, you can actually do this. So this is also, again, how you are seeing it structured. I have the full word, like the deputy was telling me today, why don't I give you the full word? I said, no, that let us present this thing like this. So that when we present this thing like this, then we can now do the corrections here and work on our CV here. So then if you now say you need the word, no problem, I'll print it and give us. But I want us to actually do those corrections now. That's what I want us to do. But I just want to show us now so that if at any point you are confused about anything, please let me know. Now the next one, professional qualification and diploma with this. If you have, good. The only one I have is the member as the Teacher Education Council of Nigeria. So I did not do, I think all the one I did, maybe diploma in a computer or whatever, I don't think I ever completed them. So I don't think I have those ones. My professional qualification is already my BS as a teacher. So I already have that one. So, but if you have done some of these courses, please put them there. So that's what you expected, eh? No, I didn't do now. Because everybody was the one that drove me. So what am I using to do when you already have educational qualification? It's a professional certificate. It's a professional certificate. So if you have it, or you do the diploma in computer science or proficiency course, you can put it. So then scholarship, fellowship prizes, and the fellowships and prizes with this. Anyway, like this now, some if you have got scholarships, if you have got fellowships, if you have gotten prizes, like what I have here is just the prize as for my thesis in UI. So that's what I have here. So, but anyone you have, that, like I said, on word format, it will actually be on straight line. It will spill over the way you are having here. But because this is slide, that's why you are having this. So you make sure that you indicate this. But you see, all these things are done, the numbering and everything are following sequentially as it's on this format. So that when the people that are checking your CV are checking the format, they are checking. And you see, yes, you say, because I read English. Yes, you are not seeing me putting dot or whatever at the end of, because it is not a sentence. So you're not expected to put full stop. So this is what some of you did. That was, at that stage, it was sickening. So people have to complain. So you avoid that. So that's why we said we should do it one by one like this. Then membership honors, distinctions, and memberships of learned societies. I think that's number seven. So you indicate that. So in the course of your work, you have gotten honors. If you have been given award, so you let us know that here. Your membership of learned societies, your professional bodies that you belong to, you indicate them there. So this all package and sell you. But the problem is that I'm sharing it. Please, they are connected on Zoom. They are connected on Zoom. This thing we should have done it before now. This is the only reason I told you to push it. Please, let me finish what I'm doing. When I finish, you will be able to. Is that my own?
These are no wrong.
Okay, she went to bring my old CV. I used to apply for professorship. So she went to bring it for us now. Okay, so I think we can look at it later. We can look at it later. So now we see now the details of teaching and work experience. Now, what I presented for was my work experience. When I started working as a lecturer in FC Okini, toward this, then the next one, I came in as a senior lecturer, and the date, the period, I became associate professor, the period. I indicated when I was on sabbatical as a citizen scholar to Ghana, the period. I indicated my as a professor now. Now, this section, because when you look at the actual CV, it says, all the teachings I've had, the presentation of your supervisions as PG, if you have PG supervision, is at this point you present them. The details of courses you are teaching. I think there was a time they would tell us we remove, at time they would say they leave it. So for now, I because my own CV, everything is there. Everything I've taught, everything I've prepared, this is there. But at times they will say, leave this thing. So I think we'll confirm this from them when we get the CV and say, okay, do they put the details or not? But this is where you're supposed to put that. So you are supervised for PG, for undergrad, everything. But now maybe what you are being scored for is on PG. So maybe what you'll be focused on is the one you are supervised for PG. That's for masters and the PGD and the PhD. So these are the ones that you give all the details there. Because if you don't have those details, you just give us that you are working so please. You don't give us details of the people you are supervised, we may not be able to score you. We have said that it's optional. But then if you don't present it, it should be an advantage for you if you present it. But if you don't have, no problem. The argument have been that if you don't have, you do not be crucified for it. But if you have, yes, it adds to your point. So, but we don't minus your point or stop you from being promoted because you don't have it. That's the argument the dean presented. So it's under this, yes, sir. No, sir. Here, you put the details. Where do we score you now? Where will you score you for those supervisions? I think that way you ponder what you put yours, Dr. Lee. Uh-huh. So that's under the point that you are going to provide them. But no problem, our former deans are here, so they will tell us if there's any and they need to add for us at this point. Which one is this? No. The one that was presented on the motion central and they were not buried. Okay. They were not buried. Mm-hmm. Even though they wrote their names like this. Hmm? The order of the naming is wrong. The order of the naming is wrong. Mm-hmm. The way now right name is that full name is lost. But no problem. We have some of the samples here, so we can use. Okay, so but under this place, you should be able to tell us if you have supervised PG or not. You should be able to provide it when you are giving all the detail of courses you have taught and whatever. But if they say we don't want it now, we can find out from HR and confirm that. But if it's accepted, but definitely because now you are going to put your PG students, this is where you are going to put them. So then we have number 9, computer software skills. Okay, sir. Yes, now you're supposed to put it there. You're supposed to put it. Yeah. Okay, so. That what is relevant, that's what's cognate to what you are doing here, sir. Yeah, that what you are cognate. Yes, you are supposed to put that there, but what I'm saying is this, because what is being scored for you is the PG supervision. You understand? So that is what gives you advantage. Uh-huh. But for me, I put everything I've done. Uh-huh. I put everything I've done. Because that CV is supposed to be who you are. Uh-huh. So that's all. So your computer software skills. So you sell yourself to let now know that you can use computer. Okay. So research. So it's put as completed, in progress, project, dissertation and thesis. So your project, your work, your completed research. Research that you are wanting. Anyway, what I have personally done is that usually if I've done completed a research work, but I've not published it or sent it or presented in the conference, I might put it there. But if you also have grants and fellowships, you put them there. Because in now CV, we have not been given that that subheading for grant and fellowship. So you can put that here. You can put, I think there's a place for fellowship that you have gotten, but your research work you have completed, you can indicate it there, you can present it here. So then the one in progress, the one you are still undergoing, maybe because material you are still writing, you can put it under the one in progress. Then you have the third one, that's number 10. Now I'm on number 10 in your CV format. Then the project, dissertation and thesis. So the work, your undergraduate work, your master's, your PhD, you present it there. You know, why it is important is that it has to know the specialization you are in. I went for an interview once, and because I didn't put it, they were asking me, okay, how do they know your this thing now? It's only a paper we are seeing. So and I saw that, oh, it was a mistake, might not put it. I said, hey, because your format didn't tell me to put it. In my university, my format said you should put it. So I now understood that, so I'm supposed to actually always put it. I understood that then. So please let us know what is that thing that you studied and how concerned have you been in focusing on it. And let me say this there. It was observed that some of you are writing outside your field. It gets a time people will ask you the questions. Please write in your field. It is very important. Please focus in your field. So that when you become professor, you can know professor of what you are. Please, let's write within our field. It's good we do some, but most of what you should write, yes, at times you write one or two things. Maybe you are invited to write, to do a paper. I have also done it to teach and all of that. Like now, I cannot say now teaching you how to do CV. I'm going to put it, I'm a professor of teaching how to do CV. But then I have to talk about those things. So it doesn't have to, even if I put it in CV and say this thing, it will not count for me. Nobody will count it for me. So that is very important. Please be focused on your area. So that is very, very important because some of your CVs were queried for doing so many things and not on what is your area. If you're in languages, face language. If you're in literature, face literature. If you're in Okay, like I am impressed by this young man's own. He's focused on his syntax, and that is okay. So that is good. So now publication. So we are going to the cross of the matter, number 11 now. Now publications. You should know what? The headings. Anyway, I think you should be consistent. It must have been an oversight on my part. Please be consistent. Please, it must be an oversight on my own part. Please, let me be consistent. So anyone, any style you choose, please be consistent. That is important. I don't even know. I'm not even sure I was asked to do to underline. I think I was just doing it. So I'm not even sure that underline is a requirement. But I don't know how I ended up doing underline. Okay, it was okay. Everything was underlined. So you should underline. It was underlined here. So me, it must have been an oversight in that place. Okay, sir. Okay. Sir. Just be consistent. Okay, sir. No. See, what they say number 10 is research. Is that okay? Then you now have A, completed, B, in progress, C, project, dissertation, and thesis. You understand what I'm saying now? Do you understand now? Now, completed, I say that what I put personally is that the research work I have done, and I have completed it, and I've written the paper. Then but I've not published it, I've not presented it anywhere, so I put it there. Because if I've presented in a conference, there's a section for conference. If I publish it in a journal of books, there's a section for that, so I cannot be putting under completed. I said, but if you also got a research grant or something and you are written up the paper, but I won't be published, you put it there. That's what I said. Okay, thank you. So publication now. So the first thing is that you consider is books. So that is A, books already published. Books already published. So that is A under publication. So A is books already published. So I listed mine here. I think I put just about three or so. So I listed mine here. Then I have, course materials. So under books, I listed my books under course material. Course material under my books. Okay. Okay, yes, please, another thing that your complication should start on new page. Please take note, it should be on a new page. So it should start on a new page. Now, okay, sir.
Hello.
Somebody wants to make comment. You say under what? Anyway, I put my under books because I'm not sure that there's people no place that it was listed for us to put it. So that's why I use my under to put under books. Even if not, because they didn't even say that. Yeah, so how can we not have course material? That was otherwise. They did not even put it in the new this thing. So I put mine under books. So what I just did, I did Roman figure one, Roman figure two. I have creative works. So it's my Roman figure three. So so that's why I listed under books. Because I listed it under books. So that's where I did mine. The one I reviewed. The one you wrote. I have the ones I edited now, but I didn't list them. I edited many course material, but I didn't list them. It's the one I wrote that I'm the author or co-author. It's your own now. I said mention your first degree, second degree, and thesis. Yes, now yours. I mentioned that. I say your own, and I gave you an example of an interview I went to when they were asking me because they didn't say that I should state it, that I removed it. So So, so and I said, but they did not say it is good for them to know what is the focus of your research for your degrees. I mentioned it when I was in the comments. Okay, sir. You see, I got a course material once that I was to I worked on when I was the head of my unit then. Now I saw there was a gap because I have written a book. If you look on that book, this is my phonetics and phonology. That book on the introductory phonetics and phonology that book I listed there as a published book in 2011. I have a whole section that the person that wrote that course material, I think the 200 level or 300 level course material, I can't remember now, did not put it. I was an essential part the person just missed. And I just look at, before I start going to, I even tried to call the person and mention the person, and I could not get across to the man again. So I had to write it. I spoke with the dean. I wrote, but I indicated that this unit was added by me. But I cannot claim to be a co-author. Because I am not. I just added that unit to make that work richer. And then also to safeguard myself, because I have a chapter on that. I am lifting actually a chapter from my own book to put there. By adapting it to now style. So, but I cannot list myself to be a co-author of that course material. So I just indicated and wrote it there that, okay, this unit was added by me from my book, so book. And I also let the publisher know that, okay, I borrowed this chapter to add to the course material now. So I didn't claim to be co-author, but I indicated I wrote that unit. You understand? So that what I did. So review. Oh, for a unit or the whole course material. If you are writing the whole course material, you should bear your name now. Okay, is it the money you are claiming now? Okay, so the HOD wants to give us information. And did they discard the old one? Then you are now using your new one. And so what's the problem?
Was absolutely outside what was expected. I met her and I told her, I said, point one, this is a review. So whether you had any information or not, what you want to know is what you want. So after when I completed the exercise, what the deal of the material was, I think it was just written as possible. Not writing.
Yeah, so if you have knowledge now.
So it's what you ask. What you ask is the meaning. I've related the fact that the initial information was not correct. Or was not
detailed. And or prayer has become obsolete. Oh, you even get paid for reviewing. That's good now. No, but if you acknowledge as a reviewer, I think it's okay. No, but really to be sincere, we don't teach. The way we teach is with the course materials. I, like me, the pleasure that I take from doing the work, like by the time I came in, I was only a lecturer. Course material will not be used for me or anything. But what gives me pleasure was that I'm able to contribute to my program. So once it is acknowledged, I told you a whole chapter of a book I published. I took it and I put it in a course material. Now, did not pay me for it. They even pay as a reviewer is good. Nobody pay me anything. Nobody pay me anything for that. But I didn't want a confusion to say that maybe it's my book. I lifted to that. So I made sure I indicated in the course material that I took a chapter from my own book and put there. But you're acknowledged as a reviewer. So what then is the problem? Okay. Okay, but the problem is this. Doctor, let's go on with this thing. This is not meant to be an argument. I think I should have left these questions until we finish. I think, but it's good we just trash it out and do it. Please, this is the work we are doing here. So if you need it, please let your department, tell your department to discard the old one, and then you write the full thing, and then you use it. So I think that's just the way to solve the problem. So thank you very much. So books already published. Okay, I've gone through that. Then chapters in books. So then you see again now, we list the chapters. Now, let me mention this. The university uses APA. I think there's a place after publication, at least I made some comments on all these things and observation. So you see there's a format that is given. And in that format, the way you are supposed to present the I think what they actually gave mostly is the double author one. So there's a format you are supposed to using the APA style. So let us, we are given this format, so let us follow it. I see some of us are using a format that we created by ourselves. Please use APA. That's what the university uses. Use it, and here we're even giving samples. If we are confused, let us ask questions. But that's why I'm giving the one I have used that have been used for promotion. And the FO has also brought the one that have been used and the promotions are passed. So we can also look at them. So if we still need, we will photocopy them and give us. So that is it. So we have the one for chapters in books here that are listed with the publisher and the place of publication. So not what we just created by ourselves. Then proceedings too. Yes, unfortunately, proceedings just 0.5 now, but then it is still good. Because at times is even the books also is 0.5, but chapters in books, but God will help us, we find the solution somehow. So this is that. Then let us go to the next one. Patents is not applicable to me. I think most people in science may have that, but it doesn't mean if you have patents, you cannot list it. So D under publication is patents. And you are supposed to see the slate number, whatever they told us that you put if you have patents. That's okay. Patents, state, title, numbers, and date. So if you have, you have to state that. So it's not impossible that you have patents. Then articles, number E, articles that have already appeared in learned journals. So you have to list your publication of learned journals. Now that the new criteria does not really focus on whether it's offshore or onshore. Some people are saying there's no need to put the country, but maybe to be on the safe side, so that we just to be on the safe side. Therefore, we put the percentage of contribution, but now there's no need for that because the multiple authors have 2 marks. A single author, you have 3 marks. So I think in that way, there's no need for you listing and putting a percentage of your contribution. Before, I think that was they used to award the marks before, but now it's not necessary again. So then the books and chapters in article already accepted for publication. Now the new criteria also is not actually using it. I don't know, we're still looking at that. But HR said it is not in the criteria, so we cannot use it, but no problem. What are we advice is this, still list it. Still list it. Now, remove your mind on that, whether it's used or not. But list it. I think, thank God, most of you, your own was able to, like I said, it is the structure and the presentation of the CV that was the problem. So, but most of you, I think you actually didn't need those acceptance to cross. Uh-huh. So that is it. So now, important notes about publication. The accepted documentation style is APA. Don't reorder it if it is a multiple author publication. And now what are we saying? Now, if you are the second author, don't turn yourself to the first author. Because in the published work, we will see that you are the first, you are the second author. And you will already look, your credibility will be in question. If you are listing your CV as if you are the first author, please don't do that. Uh-huh. Then just put your own name in bold in fonts to distinguish and focus it. So just highlight your name. Then we'll be able to know, okay, this is you there. Then avoid incomplete titles. And that's where we come to people that know themselves. They will put one title with some this thing inside the for the article, and then we'll find another thing where they will say maybe somebody will say credit accreditation. They will say their own will say the credit. Uh-huh. So please don't put in complete titles. Put complete your titles. This present your work as PhD liaison. Uh-huh. Then show all your publications are properly listed. They are properly listed. Some of you are listing journal under chapter. You are listing under this. Please list them as APA and list them under the correct places. Now ensure that all accepted papers are also properly listed with their full documentation information. If it is journal that accepted and gave you, they must have a name, they must have a title for the journal, they must have the volume and the issue. So you should list it properly. And you must also have a date. But they are not giving you a date, so put forthcoming. Uh-huh. So that is it. Then ensure that indicate with asterisk publication since after last promotion with single asterisk. But if you have been considered before and you didn't cross, then do double asterisk for if you are now representing and you have new additional publications since after that. Then I'm also encouraging you to publish, and this is another thing I think is important. I will tell you one thing that helped me. Professor Akunyili, she's a pharmacist. She was a pharmacist. She was a professor of pharmacy. But an interview I listened to, people are saying, oh, the person asked her, they thought they dashed her professorship because she became minister or something. I watched the interview and she said, no. She said, well, if you know what is required to become a professor, you know that nobody can dash you. That you have to have spread intercontinental wide and all of that. I mean, I picked that from her. So since then, I make sure I publish in the West, I publish in the East, I publish in the Oceania, I make sure I spread in Europe, I spread my publications. Yeah, I consciously did it. You cannot say it because you know me that you publish. I think I sent the paper to Canada once. The man wrote nonsense because maybe it's a racist, because I was writing about black, what is it called now? Richard Wright. That wrote the blackboard. And maybe he didn't write like the analysis. He didn't like, I sent this somewhere else. And it was published in the Bible president, they have never even looked at this book from this perspective before. And it didn't got very high rating from the reviewer. I mean, I don't know anybody for that. But the good thing, one good point the man made, in all things, other points, I know they are racist points, but the good point he made, I used it and added it to my work. I consciously was spread, since I listened to that interview, I was a very young scholar then. I can't even remember what level I was there. But I consciously, since I started doing my international publishing, spreading, making sure I spread my work across the continent. So, and you can still do that. So we don't have to be doing that man, no man publishing. So it establishes us as a scholar that actually are serious and know what they're doing. So I really want to personally advise all that. So that will help your career progression, international recognition, whether it is being used or not. It's not because of HI index. Nobody doesn't have to come and tell you about that. But you do your work, you present your work, and I'm telling you, your work will speak for you. So that is just what point I want to do. If it HR is against it or not, it doesn't matter. The CV is you. It doesn't matter. You should put it. Then I forgot to say something. Please, some of us, we are just presenting our acceptance and this issue. Okay, no, that one is under conference. So I've mentioned that, please, what you should do if you are presenting your accepted papers inside your therapy, don't give us full details. It may, like I said, it may not be counted, but put it, please. And none of you needed it to cross. You don't understand it. See, when we had the meeting, HR was saying that because in the new criteria, in the old criteria, I think the file is there, it was stated clearly that your acceptance letter must be not more than 3 years. Is that okay? Uh-huh. But in the new criteria, there's no way where anything is mentioned about acceptance letter. But I said that because your CV is your full package, so we put everything about you there. So put your acceptance letter. So if it is counted or not, put it. Is that okay? So now, don't put your mind on that. You are counting it as part of your publication. That's what I'm telling you. Because HR did not allow us to use it the last time. Uh-huh. But then, they put it. What if you get to Central and it's being used? But like I said, none of you needed it. But please put it. So that's what I'm saying. So technical report. The next point there is technical reports and monographs, not applicable for me. So if you have done technical reports, or maybe I don't know, I cannot remember if I... Okay, I think I've had, but I've never used them. I've had the technical reports I've had to write, but I've not used them. So, a monograph, not applicable. That's what I put. So, you may know. The major conference attended with paper rate. Now, this is another point. Now, we use not to score. It's required for us to put, but it's used not to be scored. You see, why there are some things that you may not like about this new criteria, there are some things also that are good. Conferences used not to be recorded before, but now it's being recorded. You get 1 point for each conference within the last 5 years that you have attended, major conference that you have attended. Now, the issue is this, that if you have published that paper you presented, please don't list it as a conference again. Don't list it. We are having that confusion with the last, this. Please remove it if you have published it. Let it be under the journal or for program proceeding, wherever it has come. Let it not be put as a conference. If it has not been published, it has only been put on the paper. Yeah, you can list it. That one is okay. Uh-huh. So you call it, call your 1 point for that. So that is good for you. Then then another thing is that, sir. Okay, that's another thing we'll talk, because me, I normally do with the most current too. That's why I do my publication. I do from the most current. But he was saying that we should do from the oldest. So the oldest to the current. That's what he said. I've always done current to the oldest. So that's what I've always done. But the teacher was saying that we should be doing from oldest to the current. I think that's what he said. Okay, so I think you may arrange yours like that. But I've always done, what I just do, I just add to the new one. That's what I've always done. So we can now adopt it, but because we have to have a format. the format as a faculty. So that's very important, because we see some people did like so let us just do that one from the oldest to the most current. So that, like I was saying now, so you have to, then some of us, you now put the name at the back. No, please put your the year in front of your name. When you're arranging the conference, put it in front of your name. Because we have somebody that he will put the date in the middle. And no, please, we are using APA style. Still use the APA style. So there is a way APA leads conferences. So please, let us follow the format of the documentation. So that is very, very important. So that is just it. So we can also have it like we have in the example that we have here. What am I going to say? Yes, another thing about conferences, please. There should be evidence. I know we didn't insist on it the last time, but then you are supposed to bring either the book of abstracts, or certificate of presentation. Because normally we have that. First certificate that will be given to you that you presented that paper, or the book of abstracts. Please, let us have evidence that you attended that conference. It should not just be that you told us we just take your word for it. Yes, we did that with the our this, but then please, we need to have it. I think it's only one or two people that presented their paper. We just look at the title, we say, oh, you have a paper, but please, we have to have evidence. Where we are going, nobody knows you. And I cannot be doing MMM when I get there. So please let us have evidence with what you are going to submit to FO, please. There will be something to present. Now, contribution to university administration and community service. Now, this was not listed, but I added it because I have it. Is that okay? So that is why some of you are saying that you don't have it. Yes, you are not confused where to put, whether you put under work experience or whatever. No. So I put it as my number 13. So I put a contribution to university administration and community service. In the first CV that was given to Ross, it was put there. But this new one, this last set that was given to us, that the FO had been giving us, it is not there. So this subsection now is contribution to university administration and community service. Then you should be able to list yourself as representative of the faculty. You should be able to list yourself whether you are the HOD or you are HOD now. You are exam officer. You are this, you are that. So if you look, you see I listed, mine is plenty, it's up to 20 something. I told you, you should sell yourself with your CV. You should sell yourself with your CV. I have from now and from where I was coming from and all of that. Then community service. All the other things are okay, like what I'm doing that is not academic, like I was chairperson of a Faculty of Arts Welfare Committee. So I listed that. I was a member of Board of Trustees for Family Instruction Initiative Lagos. I listed that. A member of Supervisory Committee of Non-Multipurpose Cooperative. Okay, it's not today itself. I'm no longer since that last year. When did I stop being self? Since after the election. So I listed that. So you list what you are doing. I remember when I came in, it was my listing my CV as an exam officer from where I was coming from, next to Kini. That was what Professor Yesuku used to say, you are going to be my new exam officer. So he just said, you have the experience to help me to take it from there. So he can speak for you. You want to ask a question, sir? CV. Work experience is like now I'm a professor, I'm senior lecturer and all those things. That is what work experience is. See, this is community service. You understand now? So you cannot say I'm professor of this, then I'm dean of that. I don't know whether you understand what I'm saying. That day we're checking this thing, we're confused. When we're looking at somebody to look for to give mark, we're getting confused. I don't know whether you're talking now. Where it is listed distinctly now, we can go here and give the person the mark for that. I don't know whether you understand what I'm saying. That day we're not looking, where is the person? What is the person be? We are looking for it. But if it is listed separately here, it is easy for us to go there and give the person the mark for it. I don't know whether it's clear now. Okay. So the community service outside of the university administration, then national assignments. Okay, I listed my, I can't even remember the one I can list. So I listed my own, my youth service, yes, services. Then international assignments, the ones I've done that are international in nature. So I listed them there. Then the key leadership roles in research and education. Uh-huh. So as the things I've done to show me as a leader in research work and all of that, I listed them there. So if you have, please list them. Like, because this is then the referees. I don't know, you are here for you help us finalize this. Because some people say because you are not applying for a job, you don't need to leave. But I've never been asked to remove. The only thing I know that the format that I used to tell us that you should not, if he's going to present, you should not be the one. The media party said because the person should be able to commend their work, you should put the person. I don't know. But please, can you help us confirm from each other so that they can, before they finalize the CVs, then we can know that, do that. So I put because I've always put. I put in mine. So that is that. But she will help us know. Their signature and date. When you look at this format, it is not stated. In the first format we had, it was stated. But then the argument is this. How do we know that it is not somebody that presented that CV on your behalf? So you should sign it and date it. Let us know that it is you that you are saying, I am presenting myself. So let's sign it and date it. Is that okay? Sir? They should put the reference. So she said you should put the reference. Then partition, your CV is who you are. Don't be shy to sell yourself in it. Don't be shy to tell the world, I am this, I have accomplished this. You have done it. So you should. It will speak for you where you are not physically present. You should thus be prepared properly and professionally. Careless preparation suggests that you are not a serious person and should not be taken seriously. Your CV package should project you as you want to be seen by the public. It is not where you show, you not go and be showing your graphic power. No, it should be professional. Then that projection includes things as simple as punctuation marks. You should not put full stop where it is not needed. You should not. Please, we are begging you. So that is it. So thank you very much for your time. Then I think if there are still questions, there are some things you are supposed to tell them.
There was a listing of somebody instead of saying one, two, three. He was doing like this. He was putting.
Yes, please. Yeah, that's another thing. Some of you did not put number. You don't number your publication. You did not number them, and it was giving us headache. And like I told you people, if it is what some people you want will be that you throw this thing away. But here we can still correct ourselves. That's why we are taking this time. If I tell you how down I was for the whole of the weekend, but I did say even on Saturday, before my wife now said, ah, but they have drugs now, that she now gave me the drug. I said I was afraid of it breaking me down. I was almost calling the woman there and said, please, will you guys get me out and let her help us do this? But I said, if I'm giving them this kind of short notice, it's not fair on them. So thank God I was able to get the strength to prepare this slide yesterday afternoon. So this is it. So let's ask question, but she therefore had to make some important points also to us about the number of copies and all of that. Then we cannot ask our question. Thank you very much, everybody. Then okay, maybe when you finish, then I will call the former deans. They may have comments to make. So that the Professor Akpa is on. I don't know whether Professor Obieje is on. I can check, but let the FO talk, then I will call the former deans to also talk.
Please.
Yes, you will ask the question. Let us finish.
Please, I'll need 20 copies of your corrected CV by tomorrow morning.
Maybe you come and say it on the Zoom so that the people that are at home will hear. Come and stay here. Yeah, all the one that you make me to do Zoom.
Please, if you are going for promotion this year,
I need 20 copies tomorrow morning of your corrected CVs. 20 copies. And each department should also give me a soft copy. That's all the people in like religious studies who give me the CV of their candidates in soft copy. The same thing, language and philosophy.
Okay, thank you. So 20 copies, she said she needs. That's all. Is there any other piece of information? Okay, I had a soft copy. Okay, ma'am. Okay, so let's have the question. I think Dr. Abel raised his hand first. Please, people from far. If you, okay, no, please, I want the, I don't know whether Professor Akbar wants to make comment. Prof, please, would you like to make comment? Let's see you and let's hear you. Professor Akbar. Professor Akbar. It's not appearing. Please, if anybody asks question from far, you can send us a chat or you unmute yourself and ask. Okay. See, you are going to correct your CV here. Me and Una today, you will correct it here. You not go anywhere. I know the book. There's no problem. We will do that. But please, you will be correcting now. You will be correcting now. I beg you.
Which one are they asking?
No, they said the one we used during the meeting. Do I know? Now give me a B. David.
The one we used during the meeting.
But some of them cannot be corrected. Some of them cannot be corrected. So that's why I'm taking time to do this. So that you'll be correcting now. You have been told what to do. Don't you have a copy of this CV format? Ah, Evo, they say they don't.
Well, I don't go keep it.
But I also sent it to WhatsApp, the WhatsApp chat room. I did. Why did you not download it and print it now? I did. No problem. Okay, we will give you these ones to do. So, but we are giving you the title. As you saw the title, you should have just written it and, under your CV and copy things that should be there. Now that is a workshop now because you are going to work it here. No problem. I will give you the title. Now we'll be working it together here. Okay, so any other question, please? Okay, Bibian, raise your hand first. Yes. Anyway, we are just following because you know down to Allah is much. We are just following what was done here. We are just following what was done here. My dear, I beg, just do what is there. Me, I don't get there and start talking story. I beg. It's very simple now. That is what we use now. Okay, that one, did they?
We normally share out the files to all the members.
No, she has given me some CVs. That was why I even wanted people to be here. You can help me guide them. Yes, sir.
Dean.
Sir.
Hello, Dean.
Hello, sir.
Please, can I ask that this you can just share this your presentation to our email addresses, and then we use that and work on it. So some of us, I'm busy with preparation for exams and other things. See, I can't be correcting the CV now, but when you send that, I'll print it out and work on my CV. Later on, I'll send an email back to you so that you print there.
Okay, sir.
Is that possible?
They must do their own. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, I will do that. Thank you, sir. Okay. Dr. Ibni Bin Ali, Dr. Bin Ali. Okay, sir. Is what? He's called now. He's 0.5. Whether you should continue to write chapters in book. So this thing that they will change up, they will change down. You want to tie your life around it, Dr. Bin Ali. Do your work because it is your work. Uh-huh. Okay. Is what? Creative work, Abby. Creative work. Let me see if my file is there. I think creative work should be 0.5. Am I correct? Yeah, I've seen it. No, major creative work is 2.0. No, 1.0 for single author. The maximum was called 2. Then 1.0 for major single author, then multiple 0.0 point, then even the same thing for minor. Minor creative work. So is 1. No, the maximum score, that means you can get only like 2. That you know more than 2 scores, maximum score for it. You know what it means? That means even if you have 10, you can only end score for 2. See, what bothers me is when people focus only on this. Like now, I'm doing creative work for my, because it's my talent. Because my talent. So when I make the name and the money, it is for me. But it's not for promotion. So let's have focus on that. We should publish because you have an idea. At times I'm teaching a class. When I was in a conventional system, and from there, I've known many classes I've taught that I've written wonderful papers from. Just from teaching. I get ideas about the concept, and I remember my one of my first international papers, I think, is for my teaching phonetics and phonology, phonetics in class, doing the practicals. It's a 2-part course. The first semester is theory. I don't get any idea from it. But second semester is practical. And then I got an idea of that paper. And I followed I was able to do the paper out of that. And it was a very rare paper till now. It is still making waves internationally on the platform I put it. So it's still getting read very well. So is anybody going to hold me for that? And it has been cited many times too. So you are not doing it. So all these things go up, go down. They go up, go down. So do your work because it is your work you are interested in. So that's it. Any other question, please? Okay, if we don't have that, we can close the Zoom meeting. I will send this thing to our email now, the PowerPoint. Then we can now start. I'll use the examples there. Maybe by then. They are taking it away. Okay. That one, maybe I can now send it to them to let them come and project as three projects. So we can now be working it. But once you receive also your email now, Abby? So we can now start working it and then we do the practical test. So I'll give us 1 hour to correct the CVs. They will give you now. This one is for them to work. For them to do their own work. It's a workshop now. So they will do the work. Abby? Please, that does not have the what is it called? If you don't have your laptop here, you go and bring it. We'll do it here. I will look at it. Me and Deputy Dean. The HOD was supposed to be here too, as they know Greek come. Me and Deputy Dean will do it. Eh? Then you do, you correct it. Then we submit. When I say it's okay, then you now go and print and you give. And all these people that refuse to form physically. Doctor Ahmad, I'm expecting you. Mm-hmm. Doctor Gata, I'm expecting you. They will send the email to me now. I will receive by email so that they will submit by email.
Yes, ma'am. We send. Just send us the format. We send it to you.
I will send it now. No problem. I will send the PowerPoint now.
I've started working on it. Just send it.
Good. I like that.
You know me now.
I know you. So
just send it.
Okay. I will do that now.
Likewise, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. They won't snap me as I do presentation. What can I do now? And all of you know snap me. Okay.
I'll come back.
If I say boy should stay here, or guy you to be to stay here, his workshop. Now I gave myself to 1 p.m. You can even take more of my time now. Mister, I think I don't have a lot of things. I know I permit you. You are going on your own. I know permit you. I told him to go and bring his laptop. Okay, so thank you very much, everybody, for coming. We are going to end the meeting now as we go into practical mode. So we'll be committing this communication on the chat and on the email. So that, thank you very much. First up, we're expecting you to comment. We did hear from you. Okay, you said they did not say anything. So let me end the meeting.
Am I supposed to repeat what my dean has said?
No, sir, just to comment. If you have something to add to what we have said, sir.
So you did an incredibly very good job. All your comments are good. All your remarks are good. So I can only clap for you.
Thank you, sir. I really appreciate, sir. Okay, thanks for coming, sir. Okay, so.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. So we end the Zoom session now and continue on the chat room and the email. Thank you so much, sir.
Cool. You're welcome.
Yes, sir.
Kudos.
Thank you, sir.